know you have your podcast, American Glutton Podcast, which in California, you think they should have an American Gluten Podcast.
They probably do.
But by the way, what do you do on the podcast, on American Glutton Podcast?
It's really, you know, another guy who you will remember from back then, Kevin Connolly. We were going to Japan like maybe 10 years ago, and we got on the plane and he was like, what the hell are you going to do for 14 hours? And I said, I'm going to listen to this Dan Carlin podcast about, you know, the history of the Mongols or something, whatever it was, some series where you got 14 hours of content from Dan Carlin, who's right. like the god of history. And he was like, what's a podcast? So I showed him, he downloaded the app. He didn't sleep on the plane. He listened to the whole thing straight through. We landed in Japan. And then the entire trip we were on, he was consumed with podcasts and just like couldn't believe that this existed and that people were just talking and having conversations. And so he became kind of obsessed and he created this podcasting studio called Action Park Media. And he, before they launched, he was kind of saying to me, you have to come do a podcast. He wanted me to do one about politics because I'm very much a contrarian and I kind of overtly despise all politicians. So no matter what anybody's happy about in politics, I'll just try to rain shit down on it. And I said to him, there is no way that I'm going to do that. It's such like a not a thing to do because I can have that conversation with you, but it's not a public conversation. It's not anything I'm interested in talking about publicly. And he was like, come on, push. Like one day I woke up when he was asking me and I was like, oh, I can fully talk about health and fitness because I've done that. And a lot of the way I look at it is very analogous to how I look at politics or philosophy or any of these things. So we talk about health and fitness, but if anybody wants to like listen to it, and you can very easily figure out that I am just not interested in the political system that we have.
Right. At all. And also there's enough shows about politics. And when you talk about health and life, and on my show, we talk about anxiety and facing adversity and this and that. And it's something that some people can relate to, and politics is just something that everybody just starts arguing about and everybody has their own opinion. And health is something, you know, health is something that's universal and that I think anybody could listen to. So it makes more sense. I think you're probably happier than you would be if you were doing a political podcast.
Yeah. I mean, I would, yes, for sure. Because I don't think it's fun. I think it's a fun conversation to have with somebody who, you know, at the end of it, even if they get mad at you, they're not going to like write you off as a bad person.
Right, and
that,
right.
I can't do that I don't think anybody can. Like, I think it's a divide that's set that once you're on whatever line you're on, and I don't even believe in the left-right line so much, but just like whatever team somebody associates you with, some team. And if that's not your team, fuck you.
You don't
and
listen.
So it's like, it's just not a, and to your point, like it's the most over-discussed thing in America.